Mr. Transformers 96 here with another video. I'm going to be talking about a newly shown Hot Toys figure, and this time I'm going to be talking about Newt from the new Fantastic Beasts Crimes of Grindelwald. So this is quite exciting. They did show two new Hot Toys along with some Cosbabies last night, all for Fantastic Beasts, which is very cool. I feel like it's been a while since Hot Toys has shown anything that I was kind of interested in for a while. I like Harry Potter. I've always liked it as a kid. I enjoyed the last Fantastic Beasts. This new one, I have a lot of problems with, but I enjoy a lot of aspects of it. The Grindelwald figure actually really tempted me, so that's the one that I'm more excited to talk about, and I will of course be making a separate video about that that figure. However, they did also make the main character, of course, being Newt here, and let's talk about him. First of all, the head sculpt. The head sculpt I think is okay, kind of at best, to be quite honest. I don't think that it perfectly captures Eddie Redmayne at all. I think that there's very few angles that like you really see it. Eddie Redmayne has a very distinct look about him, so I would think that that would make it easier for them to make the figure of. This looks like a much younger version of Eddie Redmayne, at least in this role. I think that the hair isn't as extremely, because he has like this puff that kind of puffs out of his head, like a lot more extreme than this usually in the movie. So I feel like the hair is a little bit tame, and just the facial features are really soft. They're not very pronounced, which is disappointing. Here's some of the baby Nifflers just while we have the pictures up. They look really fun. Those are great accessories. Although they're only seen in the movie for one scene, I think that they're going to kind of be fan favorites, so those will be nice that you get. I love that you get the suitcase, of course. Okay, you can stack them all up. They all look great. And I do like that the one is holding a coin. It would be nice if they did have multiple ones holding, you know, different pieces of shiny bits and gold and things like that. You do, of course, get the Fantastic Beasts book, which is really cool. Looks like it actually has print in it. It would be cool if it's like every page has print. And of course, you get Picket. Picket looks slightly big, you know, maybe slightly out of scale. Nothing terrible, but something that kind of is noticeable. And then, of course, you get his wand. Going over, and then the costume itself. I think the costume looks nice. The jacket looks a little thick. I wish that they thinned that out a little bit. And then the gray jacket. I don't think that he wears the gray jacket very much, if I'm not mistaken. I feel like he wears it at the beginning of the movie, but I don't think he wears it much in the film. I could be wrong on that, though, but it's just like I feel like there's more costumes that he wears a bit more and that would be a bit more suited for the figure here. However, it still looks fine, and I do think that this is a decent figure. To be honest, I think the face sculpt really hurts it because the face is really not Eddie Redmayne, which I think is definitely a huge issue and will be a huge issue for a lot of people. But just going over exactly what he comes with. I talked about most of it. You get the suitcase, which is really cool. That's a nice big accessory. You get five little creatures, and then if you buy the exclusive set, you will get the actual Niffler, not just his kids, and he's, you know, slightly bigger than them, which is really cool. That's a nice exclusive accessory. I think that both of the exclusive accessories that they're giving out for these Fantastic Beasts figures are really, like, solid and worth buying the exclusive version of. You get his wand, which is attached to his hand, which I think is very interesting. It would be really cool if he came with a wand that wasn't attached, just so that you can maybe put it in a pocket, maybe have him just kind of holding the wand and not holding it like he's about to cast a spell, something like that. But, you know, I do like that one hand at least has it attached, because it's such a small accessory, I could see it falling out quite easily. And then he comes with a base, pretty standard looking base, rectangle, and has just a very small environment, you know, print on it, nothing special. And then, of course, you get the figure himself. One issue I have, this is a big issue, with both Newt and Grindelwald, is their lack of magical, like, effect pieces. I really don't understand how they don't have any sort of magical effect pieces that can be attached to the wand, like little spirals of, like, blue or green, you know, kind of effects, or anything like that. Like, how he could just not come with that? I mean, you really can't express them using their magic. You really just have to be, like, them pointing the wand, you know? Nothing coming off of it. It could make it so much more visually interesting. It would be very cheap. It's just a small little piece of plastic accessory that would need to come with them. It's a no-brainer in my opinion, and I'm just kind of shocked that they don't come with it. It's actually quite disappointing, to be honest. It's my most disappointing thing about Grindelwald, to be honest. But yeah, overall, I think that this figure is okay. It has a likeness that resembles the actor. It resembles a younger version of the actor. Like, that looks a lot more like the kid who plays the younger version of Eddie Redmayne in the movie at Hogwarts than it does Eddie Redmayne himself, to be quite honest. So I have a major issue with that head sculpt. The costume, I could be wrong about this one, and I am seeing the movie again in just a couple hours. I'm going to see it in IMAX, actually, and there I'll have to really like pay attention to the costumes that he wears, because I don't think that he wears this gray costume with like the orange under vest for more than just the like beginning scenes, if I'm not mistaken. But you do get some nice accessories with him. You get a lot of really cool creatures. Like, creature-wise, there's nothing that else that I could have asked for, because any other creature that would be cool for him to come with would just be way too massive. But all of the small creatures he comes with, which is really cool. I love the book. I love the suitcase. You get some nice accessories with him, but a lacking of an effect piece, a head sculpt that's quite lacking, a costume that's a little bit lacking in my opinion. Just all together accumulates into a little figure that's kind of less than great, to be quite honest. So there you go, that's my thoughts on the new Fantastic Beasts: Crimes of Grindelwald Newt figure. I will be doing a video on Grindelwald. That's the one that I'm a lot more interested in. So I will be making a video of him next. But yeah, let me know what you guys think of the figure, and thanks so much for watching.